What's up? This is Doc Coyle from the band God Forbid, and you are on barebonesmusic.com.
Evil G, barebonesmusic.com. I'm here with Doc Coyle from God Forbid. Just out with Five Finger Death Punch, you took over for Throwdown, who had to back off the tour. How was that tour for you guys?
It was actually a really good tour. I mean, we knew you know it was going to be a big tour. They're pretty much like exploding right now, man. Band is really huge, but we actually went over really really well. I think you know our music, you know, kind of you know they're a heavy band, but they just happen to have songs that are on the radio, and they have, you know, a crossover, and you know, so for us it's probably the most directly mainstream tour I'd say we've done, but you know, we did surprisingly really well. I think the only hindrance was the fact that we were out of the tour so late, so we weren't necessarily advertised, right. So you know, I'm sure a lot of people just didn't know, even if they were already fans of our band, didn't know what we were playing until they got there,
right.
So, you know, and halfway through the tour, that seemed to get better. You know, as the longer on the tour, there was more of awareness that we were playing. But it was a great tour. It definitely seemed to pick up a lot of fans. Definitely, we'd have people come up, just say, never heard of you. I'm totally converted. Go and get all your CDs tomorrow and stuff. And it's good. And that's the purpose of, you know, supporting other bands, is that you want to try and expand your fan base. And that's how you keep going, especially when you've been around as long as we have.
Right.
You have to constantly be regenerating your audience, you know, and that's pretty much the past year what we've been doing. And we toured with Lamb of God, you know, huge tour, you know, doing like 3,000 people a night,
right?
And that's what that tour is about, Mayhem tour, you know, just constantly. There's new people who don't know who aren't aware about the band, even if you've been around for a long time, and you have to refresh that. So, you know, and thankfully we've gotten a lot of big tours, and that, you know, in terms of the live avenue, we've done really well, and hopefully that'll continue to kind of keep things at a high level for us. You know, we change every album though. You know, we've never made the same album twice. We constantly, you know, when people think we're gonna go right, we go left.
Right.
And there's always been a great deal of artistic integrity in our songs. We don't just write, you know, we didn't start singing and all of a sudden write 3-minute pop songs.
Right.
You know, we didn't.
Sure.
You know. You know, even though the songs did get more focused and more structured, you know, but we're still, you know, but we've always had that, I think, element of, creativity and just doing things outside of the box that a lot of our peers wouldn't do musically, you know. So, I'm very comfortable with that, and I'm not, you know, I'm past that point of trying to appeal to some sort of underground credibility. Because I think not doing what you want to do, you know, just to be heavier
right,
would actually
sure.
be selling out in a different kind of way, because you'd be selling yourself. You're just trying to appease someone instead of trying to, you know, appeal to yourself.
Right.
You know, and that's what we want to hear. I don't, you know, unfortunately, I don't want to be in a band that's just screaming all the time. You know,
right.
It'd be different if our band was, you know, we wrote songs that were aggressive all the time, but they're not. There's a lot of peaks, a lot of valleys, a lot of melody, like you said.
Sure.
You know, and there's also you know, we have a solid foundation in just traditional heavy metal, you know, which requires something vocally with a little more finesse, you know.
Was the actual song Earthsblood kind of like your epic type of song? Because there's so many dynamics in that song.
I think when we were writing, we just became... We were in this space of like jamming and like really just like, and we just kind of had these like instrumental sections that would just would build and mold and kind of morph into different things, and I think that's the kind of the the seed of like progressive music is that, you know, you have these instrument, these musicians who are really having fun playing. I mean, but we kind of had songs like that going back into like Determination. You know?
Yeah.
So the song Determination itself was two parts. It's like a 7-minute song, really exploratory, doing different things. So it's, in a way, it's kind of, I don't want to say reverting back, but kind of getting, you know, acquainted with some of our older roots and expanding on that. You know, and also being influenced, you know, there's a lot of really great progressive bands now, like Opeth and Gojira and Mastodon,
right,
that we're really huge fans of. And I think that seeped into our into our sound as well. And, you know, and we were just trying to do something that our, you know, other bands in our genre wouldn't do.
Right.
So, you know, and it worked. You know, the next album, we'll probably do something different, you know, and we probably won't have any songs that are 6 or 7 minutes long. We might, right, but I don't know.
I'm completely going to avoid the whole thing that happened with your brother, mm-hmm, ahead of time, because I know now you have Matt, mm-hmm, who was now a permanent member of the band. And yep, what I want to know is, how are you guys gelling now as a band, as a unit? Are things coming together? Do you feel more, you know, comfortable now as a complete solid group again? I mean,
I'd have to say definitively yes. I mean, one thing Matt brought to the table was just a great amount of enthusiasm and positive energy, you, mm-hmm, know. And he wants to be here.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he wants to be on the road. He wants to write, you know. And after the Mayhem tour, you know, then I ended up going out with Lamb of God, and then I came home, and I was going through some rough stuff personally, you know, where I was kind of questioning everything, and Matt kind of, you know, he was writing music, and he was showing me stuff, and it kind of inspired me, and got me going, and got me in the mood to start writing again, and getting this whole thing going. So, you know, he's just a great guy, you know, mm-hmm, and he gelled with the band immediately, and that's, you know, and everything else kind of followed after that,
right,
you know, and you know, and that's, I think it's really important, you know, is to just the chemistry, you know, and can you live together? Can you be in the same space?
Right.
You know?
Well, I mean, you guys have been around since 99, and you know, you and your brother had been doing all the writing. So,
it's different. It's going to be different.
Yeah. Like,
I mean, there's no way around,
right,
that,
sure,
you know, that Dallas, you know, had, his impact was huge, you know, mm-hmm, was very creative. And, you know, and the way me and Dallas wrote together was one way, and now the way me and Matt write together, it's going to be something different, you know, you can't really avoid that. But hopefully it's, you know, it's just another chapter, and I don't know what's going to happen, and I don't know, you know, could suck, could be great. I don't know, you just try and figure it out along the way.
You know? So you knew you, after Five Finger Death Punch tour, you'd be heading out with Kittie, mm-hmm, and how's that tour going right now? Like I say, it's just kind of getting off the ground, isn't it?
And this, we're about a week and
week
a half
in the tour.
It's actually going really well. You, yeah, know, they're such good people. You know, we have Periphery out, and they're just like, you know, just great positive energy. Everyone's having fun together. Everyone's hanging out. There's no egos. There's none of that,
right,
that bullshit. You know, and
sure,
and you know what? And actually, really great band. You know, I hadn't seen them in a few years, and their new lineup is just killer. They sound great. They rock out, so it's a pleasure to be out with, you know, and they have fun too, you know.
Yeah.
That's the thing, you can tell they really enjoy it, and it's good to have that, you know, because sometimes you tour bands who are kind of, I'll say they're all business, but it's, mm-hmm, they don't necessarily have that same spark, you know, or you know, just joy, you know, and it's good to be around that, you know. But it's fun. The tour is actually doing pretty well.
Good.
You know, because I was one, you know, I didn't know how I was going to do, because we're kind of coming from different,
right, yeah,
you know,
I mean,
genres, I guess, you know, of metal, but it seems to be working.
Yeah, I wouldn't have thought of that pairing initially, thinking, mm-hmm, of God Forbid and Kittie going out together, but I mean, the audiences are responding well to kind of the whole,
yeah,
the,
yeah, whole, it's not, whole mix, yeah, of, yeah, it's not like, you know, there's like an exodus, like,
sure,
people leaving and stuff, you know. It's like people seem to, you know, our fans seem to enjoy them, and, mm-hmm, their fans seem to enjoy us, and you know, Periphery is doing great on the tour, so it's a good tour. I'm actually pleasantly surprised.
All right, Doc Coyle, God Forbid, Earthsblood, best of luck to you, God Forbid, and side projects and everything else. Thanks for joining us, man.
Thanks for having me. All right.